Hello and welcome back to the PolyKid channel. Being sidetracked on various projects, I finally got back working on the polyphonic synthesizer based on my analog voice card design. In this video, I'm going to look into designing a mainboard that holds 8 voice cards and all its needed components. That means in the end, I will have a fully programmable polyphonic synthesizer with 8 independent voices. I have already built an analog polysynth with 6 voices, but its design is not very flexible and hard to extend. This is why I decided for a new approach with voice cards, which allows scalability and reuse of components. One of the voice cards is containing all parts of a full synthesizer voice. This would be an oscillator, an envelope generator, a filter and a voltage controlled amplifier. All parameters of the card are voltage controlled and brought to the outside. If you haven't seen the video series on it, I'm going to link it in the description below. The synthesizer will be controlled by a microcontroller through a digital to analog converter. This allows control of all parameters of the voice cards and even to store a set of parameters as patches. There will be a separate control board for user input and a board for CV input for external control of parameters. The pitch of the voices will be controlled by MIDI and it should even allow the usage of a keyboard that supports velocity. All voices are summed up in a mixer on the output. For the microcontroller, I decided to use an Atmega 2560. It is part of the Arduino universe and programming it is easy accessible for a lot of people. It got plenty of I/O ports that are needed to control 8 of the voice cards. I/O is 5 volts, which comes in handy as well. I'm going to use a 16-bit DAC with 8 channels. It has a fast SPI interface and needs an external 5V reference voltage. This configuration here also allows negative voltage, which is needed for pitch control and output panning. Control voltages are limited by the 8 channels of the DAC, so I'm using multiple 4051D multiplexers with hold capacitors to control the parameters of the voice cards. The capacitor and op-amp buffer is holding the control voltage for a certain amount of time until it gets refreshed in the next cycle or update of the parameter. There's a set of parameters which needs a separate control and some of the parameters are tied together on all voice cards. For example, pitch control has a separate voltage on every voice, same goes for gate control. These parameters are most likely different on every voice that is playing. Filter controls, panning and others are tied together and are the same for every of the 8 voice cards. I'm using a Neurorack power supply, which offers plus and minus 12 volts and plus 5 volts. In addition, there are minus 5 volts needed. There is a 7905 linear voltage regulator on the mainboard to deliver that voltage. There is a 6N137 optocoupler, which is needed for MIDI input and is connected to one of the serial ports of the microcontroller. There are connectors for external input signals and I/O pins of the Atmega, for example I2C and SPI port. All signal outputs of the voice cards are mixed together in a simple op-amp configuration. There are 2 mixing circuits for left and right output. The PCB layout is straightforward. There are 8 pin header rows which are holding the voice cards, a microcontroller and all needed circuitry which I discussed before. I decided for a large board to make the layout as simple as possible. Even though it was hard enough to finish the layout and has been the most complex board I did so far. I finished the first prototype of the mainboard and soldered 8 of the voice cards together. I also started programming the microcontroller. The DAC is already working. There is MIDI input and basic control of parameters via MIDI CC messages. There is still a lot of functionality missing, and I would like to have software LFO and envelope generator via the digital to analog converter. Next steps would be continue with the software development, create a control board and input board for external control, and building a case. Alright, that's all for today. If you enjoy content like this, please consider subscribing to my channel. See you next time and bye for now.